God be with you, and welcome to St. James the Apostle Church in Perth, Ontario, Canada, as we celebrate the resurrection of our Savior Jesus Christ on this, the sixth Sunday of Easter, or the 9th of May in the year of our Lord, 2021. Today is also Mother's Day. We give thanks for our mothers and grandmothers, our stepmothers, and the women in our lives. We welcome all our members and friends worshiping with us wherever you may be. I want to say a special hello to Donna Bell, to Norma Bellamy, to Arlene Bellinger, and to Don Best today. You'll find the order of service and the readings for this day on our website, stjamesperth.ca, and in our weekly parish email. If you'd like to be added to that weekly email, please just let us know. We are grateful for every opportunity to worship and connect with you. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
May his grace and peace be with you.
May he fill our hearts with joy.
Let us pray. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Merciful God, you have prepared for those who love you riches beyond imagination. Pour into our hearts such love toward you that we, loving you above all things, may obtain your promises, which exceed all that we can desire. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the Book of Acts. While Peter was still speaking, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who heard the word. The circumcised believers who had come with Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on the Gentiles, for they heard them speaking in tongues and extolling God. Then Peter said, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit just as we have?" So he ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then they invited him to stay for several days. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm number 98. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things.
With his right hand and his holy arm has he won for himself the victory.
The Lord has made known his victory. His righteousness has he openly shown in the sight of the nations.
He remembers his mercy and faithfulness to the house of Israel, and all the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God.
Shout with joy to the Lord, all you lands. Lift up your voice, rejoice and sing.
Sing to the Lord with the harp and the voice of song.
With trumpets and the sound of the horn, shout with joy before the King, the Lord.
Let the sea make a noise and all that is in it, the lands and those who dwell therein.
Let the rivers clap their hands and let the hills ring out with joy before the Lord, when he comes to judge the earth.
In righteousness shall he judge the world and the peoples with equity.
A reading from the first letter of John. Everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ has been born of God, and everyone who loves the parent loves the child. By this we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we obey his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome. For whatever is born of God conquers the world. And this is the victory that conquers the world, our faith. Who is it that conquers the world but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came by water and blood, Jesus Christ. Not with the water only, but with the water and the blood. And the Spirit is the one that testifies, for the Spirit is the truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. John.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus said, "As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down his life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you. And I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another." This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I speak in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus says, "Love one another as I have loved you." It's a command given to the disciples of Jesus both yesterday and today. Not as a master toward a servant, but as one friend toward another. For these disciples, that must have come as a bit of a shock, for their entire society was based on levels of hierarchy, which is not all that different from ours today. Nothing was equal. Nothing in the political realm, nothing in the religious realm, nothing within a household. Always there was someone who was over someone else, right down to birth order and gender. Even among the servants and the slaves, seniority ruled. When governed by a society that was non-equal, how can you come to terms with a command from your leader to begin a new way of being? As equals, as friends, as perhaps a band of brothers, such as those disciples were. That on the surface might sound not so difficult, and yet those same disciples competed for positions of leverage with Jesus. Oh, let me be your right hand. Let me be your left hand, pleaded James and John, and had their mother plead on their behalf as well. Meanwhile, Peter sort of grew into a higher level of closeness with Jesus as his rock. And now Jesus is seeming to want to erase that very thing. You are my friends if you do what I command you, that you love one another as I have loved you. Friends? Equals? Bound together not by hierarchy, not by power, but by love. And a love that requires a total commitment as you lay down one's life for one's friend. It would be oh so simple for us if we just let our minds convince ourselves that these words are not meant for us. But they were given exclusively to those disciples, that close band of brothers, that they and they alone are commanded to love one another. If only Jesus was that simple. But Jesus is anything but simplistic. No, I'm afraid that we're not off the hook. Jesus' entire ministry is about equality. Equality of genders, the woman caught in adultery. Who then can cast the first stone, he asks. And Jesus' petitions about divorce, where he attempts to level the playing field that is tilted almost exclusively towards the male. Equality of masters versus servants or slaves. The rich man parables, where lesser is given greater responsibility. Equality of religious connotations. The Good Samaritan and the woman at the well, which is a twofer, gender and religion. I think for Jesus, equality was one of his key messages. We are equal, and because we are equal, we can love one another as he loves us. I was delighted earlier this week when Peter Woodwork emailed me and asked if his selections of hymns would fit in with my sermon, because they fit perfectly. The last one especially, "The Beloved Jesus Loves Me." It's a children's hymn that says all we really need to know. Yes, Jesus loves me, always and forever, through life and into death. I expect that you'll be belting those words out sitting at home, if not out loud, within your heart and your mind and your soul, because they're as ingrained in our minds and our bodies as the Lord's Prayer is, at least in mine. Jesus loves me, though, is just half of the commandment. I am commanded to love others just as Jesus loves me. It's another tough commandment from Jesus, from one friend to another. And if we can love one another, if we can become true equals within that love, then we will bear fruit that will last. Not fruit that will ripen too fast and spoil, but fruit that will last. It's the fruit of equality covered by love. Now we can begin to see that this new commandment is not really just for that band of brothers, but for all of us. For all of us who have been chosen by Jesus. Jesus says, "You did not choose me, but I chose you." Psalm 139, verse 13, which we didn't read today, says, "For it was you who formed my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb," referring to God's hand in our very being. Jesus chose each one of us as our spirit was solidifying in our mother's womb. We are chosen by Jesus. Sometimes it takes us a lot longer to recognize that fact and accept and receive Jesus's love. We may think that we are choosing Jesus, but Jesus chose us long before we got around to saying, "Yes, Jesus loves me, and I love Jesus too." The stage has been set. The curtain has been pushed aside or torn asunder. And we, our own band of brothers and sisters, have been prepared to take center stage, to answer the command of Jesus to love one another as he has loved us, and as a result of that love, we shall bear fruit that will last. The apple and the pear will be equally firm and sweet. The strawberry and the raspberry will be equally succulent. The lion shall lie down with the lamb, and God's kingdom will come here on earth as in heaven. Because we are the chosen ones, and we can love one another as Jesus has loved us. Amen. Amen.
As I have loved you.
confess our faith as we say together, we believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten from the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me, yes, Jesus loves me, yes. Jesus loves me, the Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me, he who died, heaven's gate is open wide. He will wash away my sin, let his little child come in. Yes.
Offer these gifts sent in by our members and friends electronically in the mail and dropped off here at our parish church, and donations made for special ministries like our community takeout dinner yesterday and the Thousand Doves Project. And we pray, God of glory, accept all we offer you this day and bring us to that eternal city of love and light, where Christ is King. We ask this in his name. Amen.
Let us pray in faith to God our Father, to his Son Jesus Christ, and to the Holy Spirit, saying, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For the Church of the Living God throughout the world, let us ask the riches of his grace. In our Anglican Communion, we pray for the Anglican Church of Kenya. We pray for Justin of Canterbury, Linda, our primate, Anne, our metropolitan, Shane, our bishop, Kenneth and Peggy, our priests and wardens. In your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all who proclaim the word of truth, let us ask the infinite wisdom of Christ. In our diocese, we pray for the Church of the Ascension, Ottawa, the Reverend Rhonda Waters, and for the parish of Julian in Norwich, the Reverend Monique Stone and Deacon Elizabeth December, and for all the church musicians serving in the Diocese of Ottawa. We ask God's blessing on Leanna as she assists in the administration of vaccines in Perth. We pray for all the members of our parish family and for all who are worshiping with us remotely. In your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all who have consecrated their lives to the kingdom of God, and for all struggling to follow the way of Christ, let us ask the gifts of the Spirit. We pray for Elizabeth, our Queen, and all in authority, for Justin, our Prime Minister, and all striving to keep us safe and well, including all hospital staff, all frontline workers, all first responders, all business owners and their staff, the staff of all retirement and nursing homes, those administering the new vaccine, and all teachers and students. We ask that for those who govern the nations, they may strive for justice and peace. Let us ask for them the strength of God. In your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For scholars and research workers, that their studies may benefit humanity, let us ask the light of the Lord. We pray that God would prosper our affordable housing initiative and move the hearts of many in Perth to support it and volunteer. We pray for those who are in need of God's help and our care, the Reverend Bill Simons, the Reverend Jonathan Asquith, the Swanson family, Penny and family, Ron, Lori, Linda, Karen, David, Joanne, Wendell, Lisa, Ken, Emmett, Janiel, Robin, Terry, Peter, Jenna, Terry, Cindy, Betty, Janet, John and Hillary, Shirley, Peggy, Maureen, Mary, Jimmy, Robert, Mary, Shirley, Jeff, Helen, Junie, Heather, Shelley, Betty, Colette, Adam, Don and Crystal, and others who are in our hearts today. We pray for all those who are sick, in quarantine and self-isolating, and for those who are afraid. In your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all who have passed from this life in faith and obedience, let us ask the peace of Christ. We pray for the repose of the soul of Maggie Swanson, and for all who have died in this pandemic, and for those who died this past night. In your mercy.
Now we continue in our prayers. As our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the Church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen. Know that Jesus loves you, and that he calls you and me to love each other as he loves us. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. I want to thank you for joining us today. I give thanks to be serving with Peter Woodwork, and the Reverend Peggy Kuzmich, Wally Kuzmich, Sandra Beacock, Steve Clark, and Samuel Davis. I also give thanks, as I have been doing for several weeks now, for those who have received or have arranged to receive their vaccines, for those who are following the stay-at-home order, wearing our masks, and keeping socially distant when we have to go out. This is a great gift, and I believe one of our greatest witnesses to our neighbors. I want you to know that we have now chosen a date, the date of May the 26th, at 1:30 p.m. to host a virtual town hall meeting for all of Perth to present our affordable housing initiative and to gather support as we prayed today. Please continue to pray for this. We look forward to worshiping with you here again, God willing, next Sunday. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia.